This is a WLW television color presentation.
Hello, Dayton, fellow Columbus, and Indianapolis, too. It's the Dixon Show, where things are really happy. It's fun and entertainment, it's sure to keep you laughing. So from Cincinnati to Hollywood,
and here he is, the one and only Paul
Crazier than I am.
Yes,
do you want to know? Whoa, what a mob of people we got here this morning. We've got the overflow down Studio B downstairs. Oh. Everybody is here for the big wedding this morning, and I want you to know, honest and truly, ladies and gentlemen, I've been show business all my life, but I'll tell you something. I'm just scared to death this morning because I know how many people out there watching for this wedding, and I'm scared and I'm shaken. And wait till you see what's going to happen here this morning. Now, there's some more people just walked in. Is that right? We have people here? Well, why don't you come through this way, honey, and go right straight out through that door, and we'll put you in the overflow. Come on. 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 If she stops, I'm a dead duck. This is the most beautiful, the youngest group we've ever had on this television show. Oh, mercy. Gordy. Oh, look at Neesville. Well, I can't believe that. Even that old fire department auxiliary doesn't look too bad. Where are y'all from? We have people here this morning from Indianapolis. Where are you? It doesn't rain in Indianapolis. Stand up, girls. Did you come down this morning?
Yeah,
about 3 o'clock, 3:30.
You got up at 3 o'clock.
I left at 4 yesterday. What? She started yesterday. It takes me a while.
It takes you a while. Hi, Annabelle. What? You got something for me?
Yeah, we kind of concocted.
Well, do you want to bring this down?
You want
to bring it down? Come on, bring it down.
Okay.
I don't know what it is, but it's something that I'm supposed to wear during the wedding ceremony this morning. Come on down, honey. Indianapolis.
We usually censor these things, you know.
Hi, how are you?
Hi,
who
I'm
are
fine.
You?
I'm Kathy Dennis.
Hi, Kathy. Nice. You live in Indianapolis?
Yes.
It don't rain in Indianapolis in the summertime, does it?
Not much, no.
No. Well, you... Yes, no, what is this?
Well, my friend and I made this, and we think you ought to open it now
and
wear it for the wedding and the rest of the day and maybe some other times when you get a chance.
Well, all right. Do you want me to open it now?
Yeah.
Hold my home, I think.
Okay. You have a new tie, too, today, haven't
you?
Well,
no, you can stay right here. Oh, I see you have peanuts.
Well,
here, Snoopy, come here.
We couldn't have, after we made this, we couldn't afford paper.
Oh, is that right?
Okay, so good. We just used anything we could come up with.
Good land.
I'll hold the box for
you. Did you make this?
It's a Nehru jacket!
When we made this, my husband tried it on to see how it was. You know, I really don't know whether this looks like a neighbor jacket or a man who's in the Navy, you know, a priest. He says,
no,
I said, well, that would be great. Because
no, you know what it looks like? It looks... You know what it looks like? It looks like something that they wear in a prison or something. Hey, you're taking that woman's seat, and she just... Hey... Come on, Tink, let's go.
Well, all right. Okay, now, wait a minute. I only got one hand here. That makes me a little nervous.
It's a little long roll up the cuff.
What?
It's a little wrong, long roll.
Well, I think it fits fine.
Well, we'll just turn up the cuff just a little bit. Right.
Okay.
Hey, listen, you went to a lot of trouble to make this doggone it. You really did. Oop, my pants ripped. You really did, and I'm very appreciative. And look, and I think anybody who come all the way from Indianapolis and make that, there's our great big ocean. Good to see you. Wait a minute. You ever watch this dumb show?
Only if there isn't a good movie on Channel 8.
Well, I'm sorry about the whole thing. You're hooked, aren't you?
Yeah, I hate to admit it.
Huh?
Yes, I hate to admit it.
Why? We don't do anything.
I know.
Are you anxious for the chicken
wedding? Well,
you know,
today? I keep waiting. Maybe someday something will happen.
Well, today it will, because today is the chicken wedding.
Yeah.
Okay,
right.
You anxious for that?
Yes.
Vivian Delacate is going to be here.
Mm-hmm.
Tom Atkins, our anchorman on our news, is going to be here. Mm-hmm. We're going to have excerpts from Huntley Brinkley and a lot of people, Governor Rhodes, and we have a lot of things planned this morning, so you stay with us. It's going to be a big morning here. It really is. And to you, ma'am, thank you very much. All right, Indianapolis, how about that? Very good. Hold on. Well, wait a minute. Hold on. We got a live one over here, Gordy. What'd you say, lady?
We're from north of Indianapolis.
Where are you?
65 miles.
Where?
Galveston, Indiana.
Galveston, north of Indianapolis?
65 miles. We wasn't in bed at all last night.
You weren't?
No.
I see you have my book, Paul Baby.
Yeah, I want you to autograph it.
I'll be thrilled. How many of the rest of you brought books to autograph? Oh, look at all those thousands. How many bought my book, Paul Baby? How many did? How many?
How many borrowed, Paul?
Ah! Where are the rest of you from Northern?
Right here.
Well, stand up. We can say hello to you.
Hi. Even kept my granddaughter out of school. She's so crazy about you.
Is that right?
Now, can you tell us what to put on her excuse tomorrow?
Well, I'll write something for her, honey.
Yeah. If they say you come to see a wedding of two rubber chickens, I don't know what the teacher will do.
We did have a call from a woman a couple of days ago. She said, my kids are going to stay out of school, but when do you put on the excuse that they're watching the wedding of two rubber chickens? And Alma says, yeah. And she says, well, they'll think I'm nuts. Well, we're all nuts, aren't we? All right. Well, we're glad you're here. Enjoy yourself this morning. Yes. What? What?
I want to say hi to my aunt in Indianapolis.
Did you get her there, Louie? What's your aunt's name?
Martha Shelley.
Well, I guess she'll know who she is. Okay. All right. What do you want, honey? Now, stand up. Now, wait. We got another live one here, Lou. Yeah.
My neighbor called me last night, and she said her television went out.
What went out?
Television.
Or television went out.
So my husband works at night, so he gets home in time to watch you. So I told her that I would tell him when he got up that he should knock on her door, and then she come over and they watched the television together.
You're a brave soul.
So I just
Did you get that, Reverend? He's a brave soul.
I just want to tell them both to be good and be careful.
Be good and be careful. Thank you, ma'am. Now, look, we got people here from the Dayton area, or Columbus. Where's Columbus? Stand up, Columbus. And one of the men who hear from Columbus is a minister right here in the...
Yeah,
I wasn't kidding you, but at least they told me he was. Wait, what is your name, sir?
Reuben Kirk.
Reuben Kirk?
Yes.
Where's your church?
Brookville, Ohio.
Brookville, Ohio.
Yes.
Very good. Well, we're glad to have you.
Thank you.
Are you interested in the marriage of these chickens this morning?
I'm glad I didn't do it, or we'll do it.
Well, actually, you see, this is all in fun. You understand that, right?
Right.
And we've went to great lengths to keep any kind of religious overtones out of this. It's going to be a little garden wedding. I, as the mayor of Neesville, are going to perform the ceremony. And I think anybody with a little sense of humor can have a little fun with this.
Right. Well, I'm also a bank examiner, so I...
You are a bank examiner.
Yes, we're doing the Southern Ohio Bank here.
You're doing the Southern Ohio Bank, you are?
Yes.
Oh, we're crying out loud.
Don't tell my boss. I called him last night and told him I'd be here.
Did you really? Very good. Are you with these women here?
Yes.
Yeah, figure that out.
What? Well, figure that out. Well, Reverend, good luck to you.
Their husbands couldn't come. I got their ticket.
Their husbands couldn't come. How about that, swinger? Nice to have you, girls, okay? I think the first thing you better do here this morning, say hello to our little sweetheart, Colleen Sharp. Let's say it. And I don't know...
Bonnie will be here.
Oh, Bonnie Lou will be here, as will Vivian Della Chiesa, Bobby Braun, Marion Spellman, Rosemary Kelly, and Tom Atkins. And the wedding will get... Just hang in there. I'm milking this till the very last minute. But we got some great stuff. Tink, put that coat on.
It's the first time I've ever seen a grocery store in a jungle.
I know it. First of all, where is Buskin's Bakery here? Now, I got to give them a little plug. Doggone it. Colleen, Alma, Alice, what'd you do with that? I want you to take a look at this beautiful six-tier wedding cake. Is this a gorgeous thing, girls? Buskin Bakery. Buskin's Bakery, who have locations at Madison and Edwards, Hyde Park Square, Norwood, Marymount, Milford Shopping Center, Cherry Grove, Kenwood, and Pleasant Ridge. This was designed by Joan Spade. Is that right? And the value of this cake, girls, is $85. And what?
Look at the corn on.
Yeah, can you get that, Gordy? Are you getting that little corn on here? And it says here, baked and decorated by Buskin Bakery. And everything here, look at the little chickens on top. And the two wedding rings, and everything here is edible. We're taking this over to the Lookout House tonight for our reception. Oh, we have more cake for you, don't worry. And incidentally, speaking of that a reception at the Lookout House tonight, the reception for the wedding party is by invitation only. But Colleen and Bonnie and I and the rest of us, we're all gonna be milling around. Why don't you all come over to the Lookout House tonight? Come on. We'll be there. We'll be there from around 5 o'clock until 7. So come on over, one and all, and say hello. And, of course, the chickens will be there. Pauline and Harry will be there. And you're going to be there.
And you're going to be dead tomorrow.
No, I am not. Everybody in this whole area, drive over to the Lookout House. We'll see you over there at 5 o'clock tonight. We'll have a ball. And then that's where we're going to give away the cake over there. That. Now, yeah, now we got some other cake here, too. Now, I don't know what this comes from the Ridge Flower Shop to Pauline and Harry. Bend over, and you dirty old cameraman, you watch yourself. I'm getting a shot. I'll sit down over here, slide over. You can do it, can't you?
Not gracefully.
Oh, wait.
Now, wait a minute. I'm going to get
some back. Congratulations. Oh, that's... This is not a cake. These are all flowers. Congratulations to Pauline and Harry. Bobby Cook. Bobby Cook sends this, and that's all flowers. Would you believe that? Well, that's beautiful. Well, now, let's save that. Alice, take that, will you? And here, you're not doing anything. Hold that. Well, you're just sitting there. And then here, I don't know this also, what this is. Can't you bend down and hold? Colleen, you ain't no good at all with that dress on. What?
I know. Wait
now,
a minute.
Just
wait.
Pull it off.
There.
Well, go ahead.
All right, it says...
It says the honeymoon coupe for rent. Can you see this? That's unbelievable.
Pauline and Harry, we rented this suite for you. Who's that? Nene and Herman?
Oh, Nene and Herman. That's Nene DeCourcy, Godlover, and Herman.
Oh, really?
And Joby and Polly. Well, Joby... You know, Joby DeCourcy, Joe DeCourcy is our Hamilton County Commissioner here.
Right. Yes, now
and,
I know.
And Joe, Joby, God love him, suffered a heart attack. You might have read about this in Washington, D.C. while he was there.
Oh, yes.
And, but he's back home now, and he's feeling good, and everything's going to be fine. So, Joe, we're glad you're back. And, Polly, you take good care of Joby today, you hear? And we're glad that our county commissioner is back. Joe DeCourcy.
See how it's spelled?
For rent, F-O-U-R?
No, honey.
Oh, honeymoon. Oh, H-U-N-N-I-E. Yes. Very good. Coop. Very good. Isn't that beautiful? Well, I'll tell you, we've got a lot of other things. And don't forget now, if you haven't seen her or not, here is the mother-in-law of the bride and groom. Boo!
Here's the babysitter.
Here's the babysitter. We call her Little Marty. And incidentally, Marty will be here, too, this morning. So, Reverend, I want you to stay right where you are. Don't you get up. Seriously, let's get this show on the road. We got a lot of stuff to do. How many of you girls took a bath? Listen, the commercials are all going to be gotten out of the way real early and real quick here this morning so we can go ahead with the wedding.
Take the bath at 5 o'clock in the morning.
What?
5 o'clock in the morning?
What?
Who takes a bath?
Well, I don't know. Did you?
No, I'm from the country. I didn't.
No? Did you take one Saturday night?
Saturday night.
Saturday night, she took a bath. Well, how many of you took one this morning? 2 out of 150. That's... Wow, look at those crazy kids. They're getting... How can a Girl Scout squirt Paul Baby?
Oh, be careful,
you'll call.
Always
prepared, yeah.
Now, did Bruce leave, God love him?
Yeah,
he's sick. Well, isn't that a shame? God love him. Is Cliff coming? He's on his way. Well,
because Bruce is just never ill.
No.
And he's really not feeling a bit good, but he came out here and played the introduction to the show when he shouldn't have anyway.
Yeah.
So he's back resting, I guess. But
okay, all right. Well, I told him he shouldn't have had that last one last night.
They have a tune ready.
Well, here, I'll play the piano. Will you go play the piano?
Oh, no.
Get over there and play the piano. You know how
to. I know one song.
Go on, go play the piano. Sit down now and play. Go ahead. 1, 2, 1, 2. I'll get out of your way. I'll get out of your way. I see a camera light on, but I don't see. Here you are.
Yoo-hoo.
Wait, I'll take Bruce's candelabra off of here.
Oh, no.
Well, no, that hides his purse. I better leave that there.
I don't know whether this is the tune that I should do. It's the only song I know on the piano, but on the wedding day, I don't think it's right to play the old gray mare. Well, I don't know. I'll try.
Do you know
who's
coming?
Always one to play in the grocery store.
Colleen, you know, hey, Cliff Lagg, hey! God love you all. I don't have to introduce him. This is Cliff Lash of the 50-50 Club Orchestra. And, you know, I'm very...
all together.
You're fine. You look good. Yes, sir. Everything all right? Why?
I didn't get the call at 8:30, you see. I wasn't dressed or anything.
But I want you to know how much all of us appreciate...
What is this?
Well, some lady made this for me. I want you to know how much all of us appreciate your coming down here this morning.
What do I do?
You know the show backwards. You watch every morning.
I know I do, Paul, but...
You know, don't get electric. But you don't know anything...
I don't get
we
up
have,
at 9 o'clock.
I know. We had all the wedding... Wait a minute. I'm not through with you yet. Stay over here. We had all the wedding rehearsed with Bruce and all, but you can play some
music. I can play Here Comes the Bride.
Well, things like that. And Vivian Delicatessen, Vivian Delicatessen is going to sing...
What, she sings...
She's singing... what is Vivian singing? I love you truly. And
I know that.
Do you? And Marion Spellman is Marion Spellman is singing, I'm only a bird in a gilded cage. And Bobby Braun ain't singing. He's going to be the best man. And Marty is here. Marty, have you ever met Clifford? Marty, are you here yet? Oh, she's all... Well, come on out here real quick. I want you to meet Clifford. Hurry up, Marty. You can leave your... See, she's got her bridesmaid hat on. You may say hello. This Cliff Lash. Are all the bridesmaids wearing those?
Huh? Yes. Mine doesn't fit my head, though.
It what, honey?
My head's too big.
Is it? Well... I never looked at her head. Did you, Reverend? Well, honey, can't that spread that a little bit?
I can't. My hair is, you know.
Is too heavy and
yeah,
thick?
Yeah, well.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Does it look all right?
I think it's going to look lovely. Now, Colleen, have you got yours? Have you got yours like this?
All there is, yes, right. I have mine.
Hers is just like this.
Is it just like that? Very good. Well, don't you think that's going to look good, girls?
Yeah.
Very good. All right, Marty, we'll see you later. Hang in there, old girl. Cliff, where'd you go, Cliff? Oh, all right. Hey, seriously, thank you very much for coming in, really.
I look like Bruce.
You look like Bruce, and you know what they're going to do? Well, go ahead. Here is Cliff Lush in the orchestra, and we're sorry that Bruce doesn't feel good, but he is sick, and he can't stay, and when you're sick, you're sick. So he tried.
Yeah.
You ready to go? Can you read music, Cliff?
Well, these aren't my glasses.
Oh, aren't they?
These are Bruce's glasses.
Can you see what's going on there?
Yeah, it's first time in a long time I can see the music.
Is that right? what's the name of this thing you're opening up with?
It's yeah.
Get Me to the Church on Time. Well, follow it. Now, this is for Pauline and Harry. Get Me to the Church on Time. Let's roll it. Oh, we'll never make it. Look at the time.
I tell you, I ain't gonna make it. Bruce is sick, and the girl squirted water, and I'm down here trying to tell him his whatever it was, and I fell flat on my... Oh, my poor...
Is it all... Oh, what'd you hit?
Well,
I know what you hit, but what...
I hit the floor right there.
Oh, on your ankle?
Oh, yeah, and on this leg.
Oh, and on this
it's
leg?
Like, yes. You know, like when you... It didn't bruise me some my other one. No, it didn't hurt my otherwise. It bruised my somewhat. But...
Oh, that's smart.
Oh, I know. And also, get the ankle bone there.
The ankle bone.
You're down.
Oh, the ankle bone is connected to the knee bone. And the knee bone connected to the femur bone. That does hurt, though.
Can you imagine anybody tuning in this very second watching this? Good morning, Reverend. I know I'm getting commercials out of the way. Listen, with a lot of commercials real quick today because of the wedding. Is Tom Atkins here yet? Oh, I'm so nervous. I tell you, if my daughter ever gets married, that's all she wrote.
Why?
I couldn't go through it again.
Don't think you can do... Well, this is a good practice. This
well,
is a good
I know
rehearsal.
It is. Telegrams are coming in by the hundreds.
Look at that.
Ralph and Charlie Orr sent a telegram to Colonel Sanders in care of the Paul Dixon show.
Oh, here's more.
More telegrams. Who's this from? Peg, Bill, and Debbie. Pauline and Harry, congratulations.
Oh, look at that. Look
at that. The Kitchens of Sarah Lee. Jim Schlinwine, president. Congratulations to the happy couple. I am sending a case of Sarah Lee blueberry cheesecake to help the bride please the groom. P.S. I hope Mr. Upjohn can also do a little something to make this a happy marriage.
I don't know who that is. Who's
the
that?
The bomber. I am deeply hurt that I wasn't invited to the wedding. The bomber. Oh, that's... The bomber. Oh, that's a good friend of mine. But I'll tell you in a minute.
There's so many gifts here,
I know,
too.
And you know, kids, that we made the society page of the Columbus Dispatch.
Isn't that something? Society page.
The society page. The first time I was ever on a society page. Pauline and Harry and Colleen and myself. I don't know if you saw that or not, but there it is. And we have our official photographer of the wedding. What's his name again? What?
Tom
Hayes, the official photographer of the wedding. He's here. Now, wait a minute. Let me read some more of these things. I said hello to Joby DeCourcy, and manager Bob Manley of the Maple Leaf Tavern on Galbraith Road is holding an all-day reception for a large group of men. 30 of them are staying off work today to see the wedding.
Oh, my land.
Decorations, all these decorations you see are from Capital Display. Which is right around the corner. Capel, no matter what you want, you'll find them. Now, don't take a picture of them now. I wanted to show them all that. I want to take a tour of the garden. Now, from our representative in Congress, Donald Clancy.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
This man is representing us in Congress.
Until today.
And this man says, congratulations, Harold and Henrietta. He made a mistake. Best wishes to the happy couple. May you spend a lifetime of joy and happiness. I'm sorry that my work keeps me here in the nation's capital, but I'd love to be with you. Signed, Donald D. Clancy, your representative in Congress. I got one other one here. Constable George Wormling, he's the chief of the Kenton County Hospital... hereby declares that Harry Chicken is a special deputy. Bob Wood of Court of Common Pleas. He says, this morning's mail brought me your gracious invitation. This afternoon's plane is taking me to London. Paul, baby, I'll be abroad until March. Well, I was abroad 3 years ago. Anyway, we got to get some commercials out of the way. I may not be here tomorrow.
No.
Get this. To Mr. and Mrs. Harry Chicken, care of the Paul Dixon Show, WLW Television. This is from... Oh, you wanted to know why these chickens are getting married? Wait a minute. Let me show you. I'll tell you. You may all applaud. No, I can't. I got a microphone in my hand.
That
come on, baby.
Little baby.
Come on, baby.
His feet are cold.
You know what? These are some distant relatives of Harry and Pauline, and they're here for the wedding. What?
There's a note on the lid. What? Okay, now wait a minute. There's a note on the lid. Now wait a minute, kids. Yes, best wishes to the bride and groom. These came last night. We are distant relatives coming for the wedding. Good luck. Mary and Donna Rubel of Lithopolis, Ohio. Does anybody know where Lithopolis is? Well, that's where this is from. And these are the chickens. And what?
Little feet are cold.
Well, I know. But we've been taking good care of these. They've been under light all night, and they've been watered and fed, and everybody's happy, you know. So now you can put them away, okay? Thank you very, very much, Mary and Donna. Did you ever see anything like this, Clifford?
It's beautiful. Huh? I just never imagined this was going to happen.
Well, of course you didn't imagine this was going to happen. Now, let me show you what the Gibson Greeting Card Company did. Now, listen to this. You got to see it. Oh, we'll never make it this morning, Colleen. Look at this gorgeous. There's a wishbone there. Can you see that?
Oh, isn't that beautiful?
Congratulations, ooh. Harry and Polly.
It's why, that's gorgeous.
It's a personal one. This is from the president of the Gibson Greeting Card Company. He's sending greeting cards now to rubber chickens. There's got to be a message there, doesn't there? Isn't that gorgeous?
Beautiful. Oh, my land.
For your wedding, we want to treat you to a real old-fashioned chicken dinner from all your friends at the Gibson Greeting Card.
Aw, isn't that the cutest thing?
Pause.
That is beautiful, isn't it?
Incidentally, another telegram. Mrs. Leonard Ashire, here, I'll do it for you. Please show Pauline and Harry's wedding on the news tonight. I had a fight with my kids to get them to go to school.
Oh.
Yes, the highlights of the wedding will be on WLW Television News tonight.
Oh,
what are you going to sing, Pinky? You might as well do
oh,
that
well,
right
I'll
now.
Oh, well, I'll tell you what. I think we'll do You Made Me Love You, Jerry, and you can tell that you give the... You want to do the
one,
other one?
Either one. Cliff can read
well,
music.
Well, I had another one. Harry's girlfriend dropped me a note, and she said, I wish you'd do this one song the day of the wedding. And I said, what is it? And she says, I taught him everything he knows.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think I'll sit down here. Okay, you ready to sing?
Okay, wait till I find my vocal.
Should we do our Folgers before she sings, maybe, Gordy? We'll get that out of the way. This is a little cue for Indianapolis, okay? You'll do it in just a second. When's the last time you girls have had a cup of good coffee? This morning. And I hope it was instant Folgers. Come here, Colleen. Where are you? Well, come on. You got to do this. I'm tired. I hurt my ankle. I got to sit a minute. I fell down. One, two, three, four.
Okay. Well, this is Folger's Instant Coffee Crystal. See that? That's icky poo. That's nasty coffee right there.
That's the
old-fashioned kind. That's the old-fashioned kind. That's the kind that's the kind right there that you used to have to use, girls. Not anymore. Look what Paul Baby has for you. Just look at that. Watch as he pours that out. See how much darker and browner and richer that is? That's because it's a great coffee, and of course, Folger's always come out with the very, very finest coffee that money can buy. And of course, it's mountain grown. Originally, it's mountain grown, so it gives it that great, great flavor. Okay, girls, remember Folgers, okay? All right?
All right, good. Instant Folgers, you love this. And I'll tell you what, if you make it good and strong, you never get a bitter cup of coffee. That's pretty good.
Woo!
Oh, better show back camera than there is in front, I'll tell you, or in front of the... Go ahead, Colleen, sing, huh? Where are you going to stand?
Right
here. You got a spot? Okay, right here. VOC, that means vocals. Don't you fall. Here's Colleen, and then we've got a little surprise for you, okay? What are you going to do?
I taught him everything he knows.
Okay, here's Colleen. Sing it pretty, Tink. Huh?
I taught him everything he knows. And then what did he do? Well, he turned to someone else. Taught her everything he knew, the way to hold you close and kiss so tenderly, the things to say, the things to do, he learned from me. I taught him love's all that matters on this earth. Now he has left me, and what was it all worth? I thought that he'd be true to me. but was it all?
The Dixon Show.
She really got her wires crossed this morning. She was supposed to be here early, but God love her. But she just got here. Why don't you welcome Bonnie Lou?
I
couldn't sleep all night. That's why I look like I do.
Well, listen,
because we're going to lose Pauline.
Why, it's really gotten to her, friends.
It has.
Has it really?
Hasn't it to you, Colleen?
Oh, yes. Who are you, honey? Zsa Zsa?
Well, wait a minute. I want to show you our fabulous lineup. Get that thing out of the way. Bonnie, I want to take you for a little tour through our garden.
Oh.
You haven't seen it. Come on. Can't you give me some background music over there, Mr. Lush? Look at this. Look at this.
Brings back memories, doesn't it, to you, Paul?
Of my wedding day? Oh, yeah, let's get out of here quick. Ah, but isn't that beautiful? Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Is Tom Atkins here yet? I'm waiting for Tom. He's the guy that goes going to do it. What?
Marion. Well,
don't say Ray that. Rosemary Kelly's going to interview all these celebrities out there. All right. Okay. Yeah. Let me. You're going to sing, Bonnie. Come on. Come on. You're going to do a number. You got to do a number. Do you know what? Do a number.
Where you'll stand.
Where are you going to stand, Bonnie?
I'm going to stand right here.
Where?
I have to stand here. And she stands by the roses, and I stand by the ferns.
Where is Marty going to stand?
Out here.
Out where? Oh, right there. Where's Roger and Iser going to stand? And Atkins is going to stand there?
That's what it says.
No, Marty stands here and Roger's...
Yeah, I was going to say, because Marty couldn't stand there and Atkins here. Isn't that something else? Oh, dear. Well, all right. Now, come on. Let's get the four-star carpet stores. Bring those out. Let me show you what they're giving the chickens for their wedding. Now, I only have one thing left, and that's Slim Mint gum. We'll get that out of the way real quick. Look at this. They are giving the chickens four complete rooms of carpeting. Now, I tell you, they've had it too, haven't they, huh? Our four-star carpet store is in Columbus. Well, let me see, it's Indianapolis, it's Simpson Miller. He's on Meridian. And in Dayton, it's Myron Cornish. Myron Cornish up there in Dayton, and in Columbus, it's K-A-M-N-N-D-N-D-N-D-N on 5th Street, and then here in Cincinnati, it's Carpetland, and these stores all contributed together to, now here's the TV viewing area, can you see that, girls?
Yes.
Here's the dining room, here's the kitchen, and here is the,
That's part of the family room.
Yeah, part of the family room. Well, I'm sorry, then they're only getting three rooms of furniture and not four. There's 25 chairs there in three rooms. Anyway, what's the matter, Alice? This comes from our four-star carpet stores, and I'll just remind you, any one of the stores we mentioned, kids, if you want to save money, that's the place to go, because they pool their buying power and buy a lot of carpeting, and that's why you can save money at these stores that we told you about before, the four-star carpet stores in your city. Okay, here's Bonnie, and here's a little thing entitled, what are you going to do, honey?
Well, we just thought of it.
What?
The Tennessee Waltz.
The Tennessee Waltz? The Tennessee Waltz.
Well, all right, we'll change it.
Why? All right, the Tennessee Waltz.
We didn't know about this, you
I know.
Know. And I just got out of the tub, and I couldn't even find my tub. You know, I'm moving, and everything is moved.
is things move.
Oh, wasn't that terrible about me, though?
I can't even find where I belong.
Wasn't that terrible about me, the time that I got that tub experience? Did you hear about that?
Oh. Yeah, you should tell
me. A lot of you didn't, but we were in Columbus at a brand new motel. All of us, the whole station was up there. And I walked in this new motel room, and there wasn't any furniture in it. All they had was buttons on the wall. And I pressed a button, B, and boy, the tables came out, and the bed came out of the wall, and all the rugs came out. Everything's beautiful. I could do everything, but couldn't find the bathroom. So I pressed another button, and psst, out come a bathtub filled with nice hot water. So I needed a bath, so I took off my clothes and got in the bathtub. I usually do that before I get in the bathtub.
Oh, do you?
Yeah, and I'm in there taking my bath, but I didn't know that Marion Spellman was in the room next to me. And while I'm in there taking my bath, she pressed a button and psst. But it was okay. I was in water up to here, sitting down. But I was all right until she started to sing a Star Spangled Banner, and then I was in trouble. Here's Bonnie.
Do you want an up to?
Yeah.
He wants an up to.
Yeah, well.
So we'll. You know cabaret. What have you got in there, honey? We got the Glory of Love.
We know that one. Tennessee Waltz. Tennessee Waltz.
Because they're getting married.
Tennessee Waltz. Tennessee Waltz.
And they're in love.
You like that? Come on, Cliff. Thank you. Where are you going to stand, Bonnie? Right here.
I really don't know. I'm just new at this place.
Right here, Bonnie. Right there.
Just give me one more. Two around, honey. One and a half, all righty. I was waltzing with my darling to the Tennessee Waltz. What an old friend I happened to see. I introduced her to my loved one, and while they were waltzing, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember the night at the Tennessee Waltz. Only you know how much I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night they were playing the beautiful Tennessee Waltz. I remember the night at the Tennessee Waltz. Only you know how much I have lost. Yes, I lost my little darling the night they were playing the beautiful Tennessee.
You've only got just a couple of more minutes before the wedding begins. You want to know something? I'm so doggone scared. And I really, you know, I'm scared because, we built up to this for so long. And nobody, you see, it's difficult. You know, when you're doing a television show, if somebody says, well, you stage a dance number or you stage a song, you can do this because this is your business. But when they say stage a wedding for two rubber chickens, this ain't never been done before.
Never.
And this is the thing that has me worried. Where's my slim mint girl?
I just hope they know where to say I do.
What?
I just hope they know the place where they're supposed to say I do in your ceremony.
Yeah. Oh, yes. They know all that. Yeah.
Who is
Where's
this?
My slim mint?
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, mercy.
Look at her.
That's
How's
what
she
I'm going to look like.
What?
That's what if I keep chewing my slim mint.
Oh, you will. Now, seriously, how many...
Shorter?
No, yes. No. Oh. It just makes you thinner.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
How many, now really and truly, how many of you would like to lose some weight? All of you, or most of you. Do you know, girls, that there's only one reason in this world why you put on weight? Now, what is it? You eat too much.
Yeah, we can't.
Unless you have a physical problem or something wrong with you, then, of course, you have to see your doctor. But for those of you who are healthy, normal human beings, the only reason you gain weight is because you eat too much.
And we drink a lot.
And you drink a lot. Dan, he says drink a lot. Well, no. But, well, of course, a calorie in that ain't the same as mashed potatoes and gravy, I don't think. Is it worse?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know about Slim Mint. We'll talk to Dan about that. Slim Mint Gum, the modern aid to appetite control. Find it at your favorite drug counter. Dan, thanks for coming, and well, thanks very much for giving every one of our women here some Slim Mint Gum.
And you know what they say in New York? What? Mazel tov on the wedding.
All right. Okay, thank you, Dan. Thank you. Shall we start? Shall we start? I don't know. Well, wait. Well, you kids, yeah, you go on out. Get your thing on.
Yeah, we got to get our veils on.
Get your thing, yes. What? Can't start. What do you mean, can't start? Hold it on. Hold it. Hold it. We got a lady here. Wait a minute. Get me on. Stand up, lady. What's the problem? Stand up.
Well, I'm a representative from the Vatican.
You're a representative from what?
I've been appointed by...
Oh, you're a representative of the Vatican?
Yes. And I understand there has been no dispensation for this Lenten wedding.
It's a wedding in Lent.
Yes.
That's worse than the lady says she's giving me up
so
for
here
Lent.
It is.
What'd you say?
Here it is.
It's my dispensation from the Vatican to have this wedding in Lent. Speaking of the Vatican, have you heard the story about the two little nuns who were driving down the road in their car and they had a flat tire? And it was right in front of the unemployment service, the state unemployment service. They didn't know how to fix this tire, so the two of them walked into the unemployment service office to see if somebody could help. And a drunk walked by. He says, well, for crying out loud, he says, no wonder I can't get a job. Even the Pope is laying them off. Are we ready? Ladies and gentlemen, the anchor man of WLW Television News, Mr. Tom Atkins. Tom, come on out here.
Good morning, Paul.
Tom, it's a real pleasure to have you, a distinguished newsman, to come down and do the commentary on the chicken wedding here this morning.
Paul, we'll cover anything, anytime.
Well, that's the motto, I guess, of your news department, is it not, Tom?
Seriously, Paul, it's a pleasure to be here. This is an auspicious occasion, and by the very nature of its significance, it is newsworthy, and if it's newsworthy, we sincerely want to be on the scene. Therefore, I am on the scene.
Everybody wants to be a comedian when they get on the show. Well, Tom, I'll tell you, we're going to start this wedding in a minute, but before I do, I've got to remind everybody that they're watching this show, and you're going to be seeing this chicken wedding here on WLWT in Cincinnati, WLWI in Indianapolis, WLWD in Dayton, and WLWC in Columbus. Now, Tom, we have this all scripted, and you know how unusual it is for me to use a script, friends. But you're going to start out here, and then, oh, I see, Rosemary Kelly is down in the lobby greeting, ready to greet a few people.
Right.
Then after that, we have some of our tapes, I guess, from people.
Well, we have special reports from around the country from some rather distinguished reporters. I'm looking forward to hearing those reports. I'm sure they will be significant.
Uh-huh. Yes. Well, this is unbelievable. Can't you feel an air of excitement? Is Vivian Delicatessen here yet? Is Vivian here? Well, she's going to sing, I understand. Oh, yes. Do you know how you're going to introduce her?
Yes,
oh,
a bit later.
Are.
A bit later.
A bit later.
You're on page two, you know.
Oh. Oh, I see. Yes. I'm putting on. Yes. And was Bobby Braun here? Is Bobby here?
He passed me on the turnpike as we were coming down, so I'm sure he's in the area.
Oh, I bet he is. But he ain't singing. Let me see. Marty's here. I saw all of her. Did you meet Marty?
Yes, I did, Paul. And I haven't had breakfast yet. And what I'm saying is that until I have breakfast...
If I were you, I'd just shut up.
If you have me at a distinct disadvantage. You're holding the microphone.
Here, go ahead. Hold it.
This is the only way I can finish my thought.
All right.
Not having had breakfast, I am not really fully awake, and I want to apologize for that because when I met Marty, I said, hello, Marty, pleased to meet you, and walked away.
I don't get it. Well, actually, ladies and gentlemen, and again, I say to you, if you tuned in late, that Bruce Brownfield took very sick this morning. Well, not very sick, but he's ill.
And Cliff Lash is helping us out. And Cliff, God love him, didn't go over any of this. And while Cliff is a fine musician and all, he doesn't really know what's going to happen here. But we'll let it go at that. But we want to thank you, Cliff, again for coming down. And now I believe we're ready to start, are we not?
I'm ready if you are, Paul.
Well, I'm nervous, Tom.
Listen, I've been tied up all night about this thing. Hey, I didn't really? Sleep. I went over the script several times. I checked the facts. Yeah. And the facts are hard to believe. And I'm going to try to straighten it all out for the people here as we begin this thing, though. And I think we're about ready.
Do you have butterflies in your stomach, Tom?
Oh, my, yes.
Yeah, I do, too.
You're going to be all right?
I may join Bruce.
You have a key role to play in this thing, you know.
I'm marrying these dumb things.
I know it. Okay. Your first wedding you performed?
Oh, yes.
Well, I know you'll do well. I'm looking forward to it. Go, have a cup of coffee or something.
I ain't going to have no coffee, I'll tell you that.
Okay, then. See you later. There he goes, ladies and gentlemen, the mayor of Neesville. This is Tom Atkins speaking from the garden, where in a few moments, a chicken wedding is about to take place. Now, what makes this wedding so unusual among a few thousand other things is that these two chickens, Pauline and Harry, are rubber chickens who, through their appearance on the Paul Dixon Show, have developed a romance leading to marriage. It all started one day when a member of the studio audience presented Paul Dixon with a rubber chicken. This was used as a gag, surprisingly enough, and was called the Kroger chicken. Members of our studio audience and air audience insisted that it be clothed, and clothing began to arrive. And then it was decided it was time to name her. And Paul, for reasons best known to himself, decided to call her Pauline. Clothing continued to arrive for Pauline, and the situation was normal until someone sent her a boyfriend. And Paul, again for reasons best known to him, named him Harry. The romance grew, and clothing for both the chickens continued to arrive. 6 months ago, it was announced the wedding between Pauline and Harry would take place. And as soon as that announcement was made, wedding gowns, gifts, dishes, furniture began to pour in, hundreds of items. Everything from bikinis to household appliances, beds, nests, even a getaway car. And so we have arrived at the date, March 11th. The Paul Dixon Show is about to perform another first in television, a chicken wedding. This chicken wedding has created quite a commotion in the social world. A few chickens have had a lot to say. And so we switch you now to Rosemary Kelly, who is in the lobby to greet a few latecomers.
Thank you very much, Tom. Yes, indeed, enthusiasm is certainly prevalent this morning. Everyone is most excited, and I think it is the mayor of Neesville. Sir, could you talk to us for just a moment
Rosie, I'd like to talk to you, sweetheart. I'd love to talk to you, honey, but I've got a big thing going here, and I'll see you all later.
Please talk to us for just a moment? Well, ladies and gentlemen, obviously the mayor of Neesville is most excited about the role, and a little discombobulated, I might add, about the role that he is going to play in this wedding of weddings. But while he's taking his place, I return you now to the studio and the mayor of Neesville.
I presume you all think I know what I'm going to do now. You are all crazy. I don't know what I'm going to do now. But it's good to be here on this morning. We've waited a long, long time for this, and I think, really, are you ready to go, girls? Or shall we get this thing started? I have the marriage license here. Everything is legal. Everything is fine. And I think the first thing that we ought to do here this morning, after I look at my script, is to say that I think that we ought to, first of all, introduce you now to the groom, who is Harry Chicken. Let's have a nice big welcome for Harry. Will Harry please come up here? Why are you laughing? And I think next, ladies and gentlemen, what we should do is introduce the best man at this wedding of Harry and Pauline. I present to you the star of the 50-50 Club, Mr. Robert Philip Peter Braun.
I want you to know how much I appreciate your taking the time and effort to get up this early to come down here and be the best man of the wedding of Harry and Pauline.
I'm glad to be here, Paul. When do I sing?
Oh, you ain't singing, pal.
I have my own pianist. To see, I saw Bruce last night and I slipped him a Mickey. I'd go to any end, wouldn't I, huh?
Is that what he did? He slipped Bruce a Mickey so it'd make him sick, and now he's got his own. Are you a pianist or a pianist?
I'm a pianist, always. But I know all of Bob's keys, so anything he wants to do, we're ready.
Hey, Bob? Thank you, Pepper.
You mean?
Is it in the script where I sing poems?
No, it's not. We didn't write you in here at all, but go ahead if you have to.
Oh, promise me, Pepper.
What are you going to sing?
Oh, promise me.
Oh, I can't stand that.
Go ahead. All right, Bobby, go ahead. I'll let you go. Do you know the key in that one, Cliff?
Don't take me out of the picture while he's singing.
Oh, promise me that someday we'll take our love together to some sky.
I didn't know he cared.
God love you. Hey, whoa, why, you smell good, too. Come here. Stand a little closer to me.
One thing I want to know, Paul. You're always trying to upstage me, and you got a riser that is 3 inches taller than mine. What are you trying to make me look like, a midget or something this morning?
Bob, you have to. Did you say hello to Harry?
Are you really
You've got to be kidding. Looks awful, doesn't it, huh? Well, all right. Now, Bobby, you're here. You're the best man. Now, ladies and gentlemen, do we have music?
Hi, Harry.
It's getting to him, too, friends. We have music now for the entrances of the matrons. The matrons of honor. First, ladies and gentlemen, Miss Marty Aldis. May we have a little applause and some music. I guess I just made a mistake. Do you know where to stand, Marty? I don't. I guess I made a mistake. Actually, Colleen and Bonnie Lou are supposed to enter there. Let's bring Colleen and Bonnie Lou. Bob, you still believe this?
Paul, tell you the truth, I won't even believe it when I see the rerun.
I won't either, Bob. Be very honest with you, I won't.
What kind of ring are they going to have?
I don't know about that. Don't wait until I get to that part of the script yet. Marty, are you all right?
She sure is, yes.
Wait a minute, Marty. You're not. Everything's okay, isn't it?
I'm fine, yes. Everything's
you certainly
fine.
Are. What?
Everything's wonderful.
Oh, good. You're going to be the matron of honor, I guess.
How come I, normally at certain weddings, Paul, the best man and the maid of honor stand sort of side by side. You got me way here behind the thing. What is this?
Well, there's not room for both of you on that side. And you girls, how do you feel about the whole thing?
Oh, we're so... It's just terrible. I just love weddings. I just... I'll miss them so.
What?
I'll miss them so. They're just like sister and brother. Always said we're for the birds.
I know it. We have had them around here for a long time, haven't we?
We undressed them little things a million times.
I put her girdle and bra on 42 times.
You enjoyed every little inch.
What? You always said, boy, are you anxious, you always said
that. That's what I always said. You remember that living bra she got that died?
My God. Well, we gotta do it. Let's call the whole thing off and keep them, shall we? Shall we keep them? Oh, I'm getting sick. Lady, Now, ladies and gentlemen, we got everybody in here. Where's Rosemary Kelly? Well, she's not going to be in here. But Roger Neiser's got to come in. And we, ladies and gentlemen, I believe if we could have the proper music right now that I see in the back there, see if our bride is about ready. Our bride is ready. Let's bring Pauline in. Here we go. Are you ready there with a camera? Slowly. Followed by Roger Neiser of the Kroger Company, who is giving the bride away. If you could just see behind this railing what I see, you wouldn't believe it. I'm going to get a picture behind there pretty soon.
What'd you say, Bonnie?
There they are!
Roger, would you get a little closer to Marty, please? Roger, you not only lost your job at Kroger, you've also lost your happy home if we ever get a picture of that. The photographers are now standing by taking pictures, and get out of the way of my monitor there, will you please? Here we are. Roger, do you take this girl to be... Oh, no, you're not getting married, are you? No. And now, ladies and gentlemen, may we all get serious. Friends, we have gathered together in the presence of this audience and all our sponsors to join together this hen Pauline and this rooster Harry in chicken-hearted matrimony, and I, as the mayor of Neesville, will now perform the ceremony. We will now proceed with a song by that eminent songbird, Miss Marion Spellman, ladies and gentlemen. Marion, if you will, please. Don't ham it up, Marion. Just sing, as only you can. Are you in key, my dear? I love your hat. It was a special creation for the wedding, wasn't it, dear?
Yes.
Yes.
I'd do anything for my little feathered friends.
You cleaned that up from the barn, didn't you, dear?
I'll never tell. Just don't get too near it. She's only a bird in a gilded cage. A beautiful sight to see. You think she is happy and free from care? You're right, with her Harry there. Ah! 'Tis sad when you think of those wasted years before her lover came along. And happy they'll stay. Ah! Love nest with her egg she'll lay. She's a bird in a gilded.
Now get into gear, kid. Get into gear. Thank you, Marion Spellman. Thank you. Marion Spellman, as only she can sing. And now... Now, you people ain't supposed to laugh in the audience. This is serious. Pauline and Harry? Stop shaking, you idiot. You got yourself into it. Pauline and Harry, I want to remind you that this marriage is taking place as a result of audiences and viewers of the Paul Dixon Show, who have forced us into marrying you two dumb chickens. If any person can show just cause why Pauline and Harry may not be joined together, then you'd better crow or cackle now or hereafter forever perch silently in your own corner of the yard. Yeah. Now shut up, you chicken back there. You ain't gonna have nothing to stop this thing now. We're going through with it. Besides, somebody's got a gun on my back. Harry! Harry, you idiot, stand still. Will you have this chicken-hearted Pauline for your wedded hen? Will you love her, comfort her, keep her in sickness and in health, and promise not to ruffle her feathers as long as you both shall live? And Pauline. Pauline, will you take this questionable rooster, Harry, to be your wedded rooster, to keep an eye on him? Will you love him and promise not to make him live in that damn basement? Come on, kid, do something. Don't just stand there, say something. They gotta rerun the tape. I wonder where Lou's gonna be working tomorrow. All right. Who gives this chicken to be wed?
I do.
Well, shut up and kiss me.
Her mother and I.
Her mother and I. Thank you, Mr. Neiser of the Kroger Company. For as much as Harry the Rooster and Pauline the Hen have consented together in chicken-type wedlock and have placed their faith in the Kroger Company to support them, I, as mayor of Kneesville, now pronounce they are husband and wife. Those who John Murphy and the Avco Broadcasting Corporation have joined together, let no man put asunder. Hey! Hey! Throw the rice. That's enough rice. That's enough. That's enough. No more rice. Oh, no more rice. We'll fall down. That's enough. No more. Alice, you'll be leaving too. Now, Harry, you may peck your bride. Pauline, you may peck him back. That's getting sickening. Both of you stand up. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the wedding has been concluded. And Pauline and Harry will now leave arm in arm with Roger Neiser and Marty and the wedding party. Slower. We got plenty of time. Slower, you idiot. Marty's the one in blue. All right, Marion. Marion, you may now follow. Bobby, if you will, please.
Well, I haven't sung yet.
We pulled it off, didn't we? And if you think this was easy, you're crazy. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I believe they have had time to get down. I want you all to watch the monitors here in the studio, and those of you at home, it's not over now. because I believe that Tom Atkins has a little word for us. Mr. Tom Atkins, and I certainly want to thank you again, Tom, for helping us out in this wedding ceremony this morning.
In exchange for an extra week's vacation, I want you to know I've enjoyed it, Paul.
Good. He's a bigger ham than I am.
We switch you now to our cameras outside the WLW studios, where Pauline and Harry are about to leave for the reception. From here, Pauline and Harry will be whisked to the lookout house in Covington, Kentucky. This afternoon, about 5 o'clock, some 400 guests will gather to wish them well. Although their honeymoon plans have been kept secret, my information sources indicate they will fly to Chickasaw, Oklahoma. When they return, Harry will consider one of the many business opportunities that have been given to him as an opportunity to feather his nest. Ladies and gentlemen, the story behind the story here today may be that Paul Dixon has finally cracked up. This is Tom Atkins reporting from the garden area of this chicken wedding. Good morning.